Hi everyone and welcome back. This is the Department of Student Affairs Virtually Me, segment number two, How to Plan Using Your Syllabus Effectively. I am your host, Ms. Santa Patton, and let's get started. So we've already established for this year that school is going to be virtual starting out. Okay, virtual, I'm going to be at home. I've already discussed how I'm gonna make my space good. I've already discussed, okay, I'm gonna have to use a tablet. I'm gonna have to use a computer. We've already established that. So now we gotta get back to what makes school school. We gotta stay organized. We wanna be successful. So at the beginning of the year, usually within the first week, first to 2 weeks of classes, you will receive a syllabus or syllabi for those that have multiple classes, outlining all of your due dates, expectations, the grading scale, what's expected of you as a student. I have all of these things. Okay, I have all of this paper in me. I have all of these expectations in front of me. Whoa. Okay, that can be overwhelming. That can be a lot for anybody. And that's okay. It's perfectly normal. So first and foremost, you want to make sure that you have indeed even received all of your syllabi or syllabus from your respective teacher or teachers. You don't want to put all this planning in and you're like, wait a minute, I'm missing something. So that defeats the whole purpose of planning. You also want to get acquainted with, again, those due dates and that grading scale. And I would also put a pin in understanding exactly what's expected of you concerning participation, digitally, concerning submitting your assignments, how much does everything weigh, how much is actual dialogue participating on the calls and the Teams meetings that you all will be having, because that's very important, because that can be the difference between different letter grade and we don't want to mess that up. So go through your syllabi with a fine tooth comb. This will never change. Some people prefer the digital method, some people prefer the old school method, which I personally am a team of, however you feel. Make sure you have a planner or a calendar to record down your dates, because again, you receive these different emails, these different files. It's gonna be a lot. Even in the email form, it still can be a lot. So if you're a person that's like, okay, I need to look at it, if you're a visual person, say you might wanna invest in, say, planners. Planners can be your very best friend. So I have two different formats. This is a big format for those that like a little bit more space. You want to better plan out every single detail as well as your life, and that's perfectly fine. But definitely make sure you are planning out for your school day, which is again 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Yes, that's important. And then here's a small one if you just want to have just your calendar dates. I know that's sometimes very helpful. You just want to write in your dates and to say a calendar form your due dates. That's always really good too. So those are just some options for those that want to physically write down their dates so they can see it and have an idea they can better plan. And then too, for those that prefer, again, the digital route, because that's what we're doing right now. That's the era. You can use your app. You can use the calendar app. You can use your Microsoft Outlook, you can use Google, or you can use a whole other host of free apps that are out there for you to better effectively plan out your time and your due dates. So that's exactly what we want to do. So yes, again, school will be from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. We got to plan and make sure that we want to go ahead and troubleshoot. So after school, that is your time. If you need to start to set up office hours, well, virtual office hours or times or conferences to talk to your teacher to better effectively understand, okay, if you have any further questions about the syllabus, what's expected of you, that's the best time to do it. So definitely go ahead and plan. If you see things in there, I would even suggest proverbially highlighting, say something you have a question about as you're going through, or if you're a person that prints it off, which that's perfectly fine too. Again, you can take a highlighter and go through and highlight things that are like, I might want to put a pin on that. I want to go back in and maybe ask a further question about. That's your time to do that. So make a note of that and then send those off into an email. So therefore you can talk to your teacher try to set up a Teams call with your teacher to further understand what's going on. Because again, we want to start out with our best foot forward. Digital era, in-person era, it does not matter. We want you all to be successful. I want to see you be successful starting out. Thank you all for joining in this moment and this time. We want to plan to succeed. We don't want to plan to fail. So let's get organized. Let's start out fresh. Let's start out excited. And let's start out ready to learn. Thank you all, and I'll see you in the next session. Bye-bye.